Good morning from Ahmedabad city. Slept really well after yesterday's 600 kilometers ride. Breakfast is done. We are all freshed up. Time to leave. Here is Purv, a RTR 200 rider from Ahmedabad city. He came here to meet us and we had a long conversation. Thanks a lot to him for guiding us out of the city, as traffic in Ahmedabad can really get unregulated. Time for the fuel efficiency test. Again, both the bikes have done the same kilometers after yesterday's full tank. The RTR did 347.9 kilometers in 9.05 liters of fuel. That gives us a fuel efficiency of 38.44 kilometers per liter, while the Dominar did the same 347.9 kilometers in 9.9 liters of fuel, giving the fuel efficiency of 35.14 kilometers per liter. And I feel these numbers are really good for these motorcycles. Destination for today is Mount Abu, which is roughly 240 kilometers from our hotel. Roads are fantastic, but I am really excited about the last 20 kilometers of hill roads, which has got some really good inclines and bends to enjoy on our motorcycle. Done 126 kilometers and had stopped here for lunch. The buttermilk served here has really made us fresh. Time to hit the road again. The route which we are taking today is from Palanpur, and as you can see, it's mostly a straight stretch until you reach the Abu Road. Finally, the mountain roads are here. I will ride the RTR till halfway and then switch to the Dominar 400. Let me start by saying that all the RTRs enjoy riding in the mountains, be it the 160 or the 180. I had a 180 before this and it used to feel like home when riding on the inclines. Similar is the case with the 200. Lightweight and stiffer chassis has made this motorcycle agile on the corners. The gearing is so spot on that you can almost do this entire circuit in 3rd and 4th gear. The mono suspension does aids in better handling, but with all this luggage setup, you can't really afford to push the motorcycle further. For all the riders and drivers coming on this route, please note that there is a two-way traffic flow on this road. So please ride carefully and responsibly. There are already enough monkeys here, so let's not try to be one of them. All this again reminds me of the ABS which is missing in my RTR. The Remora tires offer ample grip, but an electronically aided ABS makes the rider relax and his ride safer. So the Dominar is here. Please don't take this as a comparison, as both these motorcycles belong to different segments. At 182 kilos, you might feel the Dominar 400 is a heavy motorcycle, but all the weight disappears at the twist of the throttle. Wide handlebars gives you better leverage to control your motorcycle around the corners. Newton meters is enough torque to push the bike further and the rider back. The good thing is that all this torque is nicely spread at low and mid range. It's not often that a rider will visit higher RPMs on this motorcycle. And even if you do, you will be greeted by buzz. The best thing about the Dominar 400 is that it comes equipped with ABS and slipper clutch, both of which can make riders' job a lot easier and can be life-saving. Now let's talk about the heat management on this engine. We have done 200 plus kilometers from Ahmedabad and we are continuously riding up hills. But there is no sign of overheating from this engine, which is a big thumbs up from my side. Now enough on motorcycles, let's discuss about today's destination. Mount Abu is a hill station, so it's a cold place even in March and April. Temperatures can go down below 0 degrees in December and January. Don't go for AC rooms, as you won't be requiring AC at any given time of the day. Look for rooms around Nakhi Lake, as there are plenty of stay options over there. We went for the one with a secured parking. As of with any hill station, Mount Abu has a lot of viewing points and point of interest. Dilwara Temple should be on top of your list. This 13th century Jain temple pictures the magical work that artisans have done with white marble. There are 5 temples inside, which I cannot show you as photography is prohibited. If possible, get a guide, as the story behind every temple and sculpture is interesting. Do note that Dilwara Temple remains open only from 12 PM to 6 PM. Next, we went to an art museum on the way and finally to the Sunset Point. The Sunset Point can get really crowded, so try to reach there early. I did manage to get a time lapse, which I will share with you at the end of this video. Evening time can be spent on the Nakhi Lake. Sitting areas have been provided around the lake, where you can enjoy the fresh and cool breeze, which we dearly miss in our urban jungle. Dinner can be done at the city center area. The market here is really happening and you can have a lot of food options.